everyone.
Gabriel Nassif for TCG Player, Ultimate Guard, and Channel Fireball. And today I'm going to be playing Modern. I'm going to be playing Wafu Tapa's latest Blue-White Control list. And he actually came in not first in the Swiss in the last Modern Showcase. He ended up losing in the quarters against Black Red Grief, kind of more commonly known as Black Red Scam. And yeah, just kind of a license for me to play Blue-White Control, right? For a while, even Wafa was struggling was Blue-White Control in Modern. And I didn't think it was super good, but he's been doing a little better lately. Maybe the Yorion ban helped a bit. It was definitely one of the tougher matchups, the Yorion Omnath deck. Maybe the worst matchup, or out of the most played deck, the worst matchup. So that might explain why he's been doing better and why maybe Blue-White's a little more valuable than it used to. So yeah, kind of want to get back into Modern. I've been enjoying Blue-White Control in Pioneer, so figured I would give this a try. And I'm going to go through the list real quick. It's playing Leyline Binding as its main removal spell, meaning you have Ketria Triome plus Rafine's Tower, which if you go turn one tower, turn two Triome with the fetch lands, not that hard. You have to cast Binding for one and you're kind of set for the rest of the game. A couple of prismatic endings to round out the removal spells, four counter spells, four Arcanist Charms, four Shark Typhoon. It is Wafu Tapa, after all, needs a little healthy dose of card drawing spells. Free Memory Deluge, which sounds like so many when all your rest of your deck already kind of cantrips. Free Verdicts, four Solitude, four removal. Not many Planeswalkers, just a couple to Fairy Time Raveler. Solid card, good against Cascade, combos nicely, was maybe dressed down in some spots, maybe Solitude. So yeah. Next for Counterspell, Dovin's Veto. And then some cards that just line up pretty well in Modern in general is a Chalice of the Void, a couple Dress Downs, a Hollow Moonlight to kind of get people who are playing Urza's Saga, people who are playing Creativity, helps a bit against Living End and whatnot, the Grief decks. So yeah, another one to note in the mana base, the one Hall of Heliod's Generosity lets you recycle Dress Down and put back Shark Typhoon on top. I played a bit with that card. I was pretty impressed. As long as you have, critical mass, like the four Shark Typhoons plus some Dress Downs, I think that card's pretty decent. And then the sideboard, some of the cards you might expect, some a bit less. Crumble to Dust, I'm guessing it's for Valakut and a few Tron decks. You've got Flame Blitz, which is good against Planeswalker, Rendered Six, opposing Teferi. You play it, it kind of sweeps the Planeswalker, you can cycle it. There's also a cool combo was, I guess, Teferi Time Raveler. If you have it in play, you can play your own Teferi, bounce it to your hand, then cycle it away because you don't want to lose your own Teferi to it. So plays out nicely. More of the same from the main deck, an extra Dress Down, a couple extra Moonlights. These cards are just really strong in Modern right now. And a card you don't see very often, a card that was played a bit against Burn back in the day, especially with Snapcaster Mage, it's Blossom and Calm. So still good against Burn. Burn is still around, hasn't got anywhere. And I'm assuming it's good against the Grief Undying deck. This way, if they go turn one or, they try to Grief, you know they're probably going to get it back with Undying Malice or whatever the cards are called, I forget. And they're going to Grief you twice in the same turn. And this means that it counters the first Grief and now they can still bring it back, but they don't get the discard effect. They just get a creature, you get four life in the process, bad. So yeah, we'll see how it plays out. Looking at the list, I feel like maybe there's too many card drawing spells. Maybe the deck could use a Planeswalker, a 5-mana Teferi, or Jace, or I'm not too sure. I just feel like a lot of your cards cantripping, plus the Typhoons, plus Archmage Charm, plus Memory Deluge is a lot, but I guess you also have a lot of cheap removal spells. Memory Deluge works really well with 1-mana Binding. In a pinch, you can pitch a Solitude too if you're too far behind, so we'll see. We will see. I've been playing a lot of Pioneer. I actually came in 15th in the European Regional Championship in Sofia last weekend. So all the testing kind of paid off. I actually ended up playing Blue White Control. And yeah, I didn't play the deck a ton leading up to the event, but it was a deck I played a lot in the past. So I felt pretty comfortable. I played pretty well for the most part. I lost a couple of matches to Phoenix on day two where maybe I could have played a bit better. I went 2-2 against Phoenix. I lost a couple of creature-based combo deck. I lost to Grease Fang and the Ignis combo deck. And they did pretty well against the rest, went 3-0 against Rakdos. Didn't play a single time against Monogreen, actually. Let's see. Kahira Companion. I don't know if Kahira is going to be good for me. Be interesting to keep track. I can see why Waffle plays Kahira, because people kind of know what he's playing anyway, so he's not giving much away. But I wonder if in the dark, you know, Kahira is not costing you too much. It is nice that there's another deck that plays Kahira. You have 4-color Omnath with Elementals only that plays Kahira, so you're not completely giving away your archetype. Would have a Planeswalker to Jakanta. Let's see. Yeah, I was going to say Grixis Shadow is Jakanta usually. Drum. Okay. Let's see. Rafine's Tower or Ketra Triome. No Fire Ice in this list, right? But there's a Steam Vent. I guess it's mostly for the sideboard and extra lands for ending and binding. Let's see. This gives me one extra. This was Fountain gives me two, so probably just get Ketra Triome. All right. I'm not too sure what to expect. Springleaf Drum, Jakanta, Basic Swamp, Minamo. Time Sieve. Sacrifice 5 artifacts, take an extra turn. I'm going to let that resolve, because that card doesn't do much on its own. I think there might be an Emery deck. I am going to just cycle Shark Typhoon. Definitely want to cycle one of the cards. I figured I would hold on to Dresdown. I could Prismatic Ending something. Sorry. But once again, I feel like these cards don't do a ton right now for them, so I'm going to save my removal. If you would create a clue, food, or treasure token, create one of them. Okay, so that card does something. Could counter it. Kind of sucks. I have 2 Solitudes in hand. I would rather not have to counter it. It could dress down if they create a clue. All right, I'm going to let them have it. And if I need to, I can Solitude pitch Solitude. Spell Bomb. Sure. All right, I guess my plan is to just dress down if they try to make clues. And so I have Counterspell mana up. Hope to draw. A land and be able to Prismatic Ending with Counterspell mana up. Or maybe even just Solitude, honestly. Now I kind of want to save my dress down for Urza's Saga. All right, that time seems getting a little scary. Let's not play with fire too much. Let's not die with 7 removal spells in hand. Am I supposed to counter that? Discard attack card, create a food token. Sacrifice it, return target creature card from a graveyard to your hand. All right, I'm going to let them have it. Just trying to fight over the cards that I think might matter. Not a manufacturer. Getting a little scary. Food treasure clues. I mean, eventually I can get rid of them all, but right now. All right, I guess I'm gonna be all week and counter, use my counter spell, my precious counter spell. And then I'm gonna get rid of the manufacturer so we don't get too many artifacts. Kind of want to get rid of it anyways. Could get rid of the cookbook. They have a creature in the yard, so it's going to be value at some point, and just kind of pick them apart, honestly. Modern cookbook, makes sense. All right, two cards left. They don't have too much going on. Looks like there's a ways away from comboing me. That's maybe a little loose. Yeah, let's see what I draw first. Call a token. All right. So, yeah. Looks like we're in great shape. Okay. Jinxed it. Binding Shark Typhoon Hall. I mean, none of these cards do too much against Urza Saga. Solitude a bit. Binding a bit. Shark Typhoon a bit. I'm going to take Binding and I'm going to take a land, I guess. On Earth plus cookbook plus time sieve. All right, once again, I guess I'm not gonna play with fire. I'm gonna get rid of the time sieve, I think. Anyway, if they want to sag the entire board to take an extra turn, I'm good with it. I think I'm going to counter the Unearth as well. Just use my mana, basically. Use my mana, use my cards. I have Solitude. I'm going to refill with Deluge. Just need to not fall too far behind.
upkeep.
I was wondering. I was like, what's up with upkeep? That makes sense. Let's see. Are they making me use? They are. And I will. Not as good as Dress Down in that spot, but still something. Let's see if they have anything good to get just another cookbook. All right, arguably I should have done that in response to getting one less life. Gonna do it now. They're actually like not that far from comboing me. Maybe I should have Hell Solitude for the 1/3 for Manufacturer. Okay. That's nice. Now I can start looping Dresdown or Shark Typhoon if I want to. And I'm not sure that's what I want to do. Pretty resilient. Oh God. Is that kind of like, I mean, it's not quite infinite turn, but it is a lot of turns. Huh. I guess I kind of messed up. Let's see. I guess I need to memory deluge and try and slow them down. Wow, that was kind of, thought I was good. Thought I was, yeah. Stick two binds, I guess. Should have done that way earlier. Well, they get one extra turn. They're probably going to take one extra turn. Pretty impressive. Art Saga, not bad. Beat downs, okay. Is that okay racing? Looks like I'm back on track. I have Kahira too. I think we need to just put back Dresdon on top. Might have their own fella. Draw some cards. Nice little solitude. Is that loose? Feels a little loose. I'll keep Counterspell Mana up. I think I could pretty safely solitude the 4/2 attack, dress down some tokens, or not really, just take a hit too. All right, if they attack, I can just make a blocker. That would have been awkward. I've had to use my dress down right away. I might just take the hit here. I'll fetch no NQ zone and evil. Oof. Just realized. Beautiful basics. Cannot unsee it. Ooh, black spell bomb. Okay. Water cookbook. It's fine. Another counterspell. I am gonna target Shark Typhoon right away. See if they want to use their spell bomb for that. If not, the Shark Typhoon is just gonna kill them. And this way I still have Lay dressed down in my All right, that was scary for a second. I might have needed to get lucky with that deluge for soul's final binding. Oh man. No, I'm just gonna counter. Okay, good enough. Alright, crumble to dust for Urza Saga, nah, spreading seas, yeah, dress down, yeah, hallowed moonlight. The land of Terran's creature within and it wasn't cast, exiled instead. I mean, they have Unearth in their deck. They have the tokens, doesn't seem that great. Vito seems pretty good. Chalice of the Void for 1 or 0. They have bubbles, they have drum. Can cast the cookbook. They have a creature that costs 0/2, right? Whereas a lot of my cards are pretty good against them. What about Verdict? Verdict does not seem especially good. Okay, so this is reasonable. I might want Chalice. I'm almost definitely want Ending. Ooh, and Stony Silence. Hello? People watching are like, Gab, hello, Stony Silence against the artifact deck. Maybe Shark Typhoon is slow, but Shark Typhoon is just such a nice flexible card. And then on the draw, do I want more than one Chalice? Trying to remember which zeros I saw besides Bubble and Asmo. All right, I'll do that for now. What would Waffle do? Not bad. A little slow, I guess. Low-ish. I don't have Ending. I don't have Stony, I guess. I'd be asking for a lot, though, to have these cards in my opening hand.
Okay. Yeah, their engine going. Scary. Scary for sure. Yeah.
So none of them make my binding cost 2 mana, right? I would need to get lucky.
So Ketra lets me top deck any fetch land plus Hallowed Fountain. So I think Ketria is better, but if I break, then I can't even cast the binding. So I guess I'll get Rafine's Tower. Should have believed in the heart of the cards. -3. Spreading Seas on the Watery Grave. What artifact can he get back? Well, right now they can't even get value out of Emery. So I guess I'll just say go and hope they break on land. They break on land. Their Emery's not doing much next turn. Can draw a bubble too. I see they draw Urza Saga, they can't cast Time Sieve. So it's not even all their lands that can cast Unearth on Manufacturer. It's probably starting to be a little much. Just gonna counter what I can while I can. No bubble, please. Attack for one, yes. Now what? I can get Ketria Triumphant for one. Seems like the safest play. I'll let them play C for free next turn. That'd be bad. Small. 6 damage to itself. Target creature deals 6 damage. Let's see. I guess just bounce Asmo, right? Could have said go, I guess, with strong mana up and then drawn two if they did nothing. Ooh, Shredder. Did not expect Shredder. Yikes. All right, so I was trying to save that for a saga, but can't wait. And I boarded out my verdicts. Yeah, just counter it. Counter it, Solitude, the other one. They have Asma in hand too. Jeez. I guess I'll just let them have it. I'm just going to draw two. I'm just going to draw into, try and draw into. Every time I play Spreading Seas in Modern, I feel like that's the way it plays out. Not even joking. Just never at the right time. I probably misfetch, so I don't even have triple right, triple white. All right, let's see. They're gonna get a million tokens. I need to find like a dress down. Also need to worry about just time sieve one-shotting me. This game looks pretty grim. This game looks pretty over. Could have found Stony Silence, I guess. That's not a reason to draw some cards. Right, it got me. I guess I'm going to yield to all these triggers. Please, they don't have a ton of mana yet. It's the one thing I've got going for me. Yep, you have all the food in the world. When you play Time Sieve, I'm just probably going to scoop. Can get rid of it, but to get an extra turn at least. Attack me, I mean, I'm like kind of dead on board, period. I'm not even sure I can really afford to, I'm not even sure why I'm playing this game. Well, it'll be over soon enough. And they're stuck on lands too. They're stuck on one land. All right, it's fine. Verdict, yes, no. Chalice on the play. Let's see, what did I die with? Enhanced Solitude. Maybe Solitude's like, maybe I should just have some verdicts. Cut a Shark Typhoon. Let's try this. This has very few win cons. Whatever, I have Kahira. Only win con I need. Ooh. Do you have an answer to Stony Silence? I even have the verdict for the Shredders if they go in Plan B mode, which is nice. All right, no Spell Pierce plays. No BS. Shredder. Okay. Just gonna get rid of it right away. That's actually a bad play. I should just keep Veto Mana up. Alright. I guess we have our answer. Did it indeed not have an answer to Stony Silence? I think that was kind of bad though. I should probably just keep Veto Mana up. Let them have Shredder for a turn. Well, that's Stony Silence. It's always nice to win the first one. Racer Man. Five lands. Not even like good mana and stuff. I'm just gonna mulligan. Better. Better, better, better. And maybe bottom Dresdown. Kind of hard to know in the dark for sure. I could look up. Look up what they're up to on the internet with their screen name and stuff, but I usually do it for challenges and try hard mode. Looks like Yawgmoth. It's not the easiest matchup. Let's see. Let's slow them down a bit. Since I have an answer to Grist. And this gives me binding for... Don't even have to get to Kitcher Trom, can just get Steam Vents. This matchup used to be tough because of Grist, and it's still not the easiest, but the fact that you have binding now is a huge deal. Huge, huge deal. Just more answers to Grist, basically. I would have cast binding if I had break that thing, just to try and slow them down and curve into Deluge. Wouldn't have been super thrilled about it, but I think it's better than letting them on tap as Wall of Roots when they have a full grip. Innkeeper is perfectly fine, even though it does give them Court of Calling for free, so it's actually a little tricky. And I guess I'm okay. I was gonna say I can get to Team Vents and have Charm plus Binding Mana, which is nice. So if they cooked for free, they could get a Grist. I think I might let it resolve. Courting for two? What are you courting for? I'm just going to let them have it. Am I crazy? Am I dumb? Two mana. Probably just a Strangled Roostgeist. I'm just going to bind it. All right, I'm going to shock. Leave myself the option. I don't really care about damage the way this game played out. It's questionable. It's kind of unlikely to just give me a break here. Either they're going to say go with Court of Calling Mana up, or they're going to jam something. Or not, maybe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright, damage is kind of adding up. I think I'll be okay, but might get punished. The Court of Calling, didn't even think about it. That's real nice if they tap out now. That's me using my mana. That worked out nicely. Ooh, verdict. Verdict plus binding. Wow. That's some draws. All right, this is pretty good to like less mana, less everything, less damage for me. Do I want to bind the wolf right away? Probably not, because of Grist. I think I was supposed to verdict. Seemed good when they're all stuck on lands, all stuck on resources. Grist, yep. Alright, I guess I won't fetch, else it might save me one life that I might need. Let's see, blue. The Fairy Solitude, why not? Just gonna buy a little time. Yawgmoth's not looking too scary. Monster token. Had a power outage today. There's actually a tiny, like, few seconds power outage yesterday night just before I went to bed around 1:30 in the morning. And there was another one this afternoon while I was streaming. Lasted a couple minutes. They've been happening in the winter. Uh-oh. Land plus... Oh. Wait, what? Okay, I'm not gonna lie, kind of feeling clueless here. Gonna get Kahira first, just in case I need to Solitude in response to another Solitude. I don't think that's very likely to happen, but... Why did they sag the treasure? Oh, Dryad, right. Obviously. One land attacks. Classic Dryad Arbors. That's fine. They get a few cards out of it. I don't think it's worth like going nuts with Solitude in response or anything. I mean, I'm not even sure I'm preventing much besides maybe one draw step. Wait, couldn't kill? Oh no, they had to remove the token from Young Wolf. Okay. Grist. Okay. Actually doesn't do much. I got the Kahira to attack into it. It's really nice. Oh wow. Is that better? We do Kahira plus Teferi.
probably just all excellent options, honestly. Let's see. Let's do Teferi on the token first, see what I draw. I could give them back. I could bounce my binding, actually. Loose check. Oh well. Better make mistakes now while I'm pretty far ahead. Bounce the binding, they get to keep one. I recast binding. They get to keep the token, I guess. It's not much, much worse. It's a little worse. Grisom doesn't do that much in this matchup. It can be nice was, what did he sack? It can be nice was Verdict, so the creatures don't come back. And I guess here, maybe in combat, it's going to be okay for me. Never mind. All right, I think this is it. Let's see, Chalice, no, ending. Chalice actually not the worst, the games go long, putting Chalice on one can be okay. Veto, doesn't counter Grizz, does counter Cord. Medium, Dress Down, not great, Hollow Moonlight, pretty decent. Just a better Dress Down most of the time. Blossoming Calm, not good enough. Let's see, the counters, Veto is kind of mediocre. These cards are okay. Shark Typhoon can probably be trimmed. Chalice of the Void for one. They used to not play Veil of Summer. They used to not play it. Well, they used to play it and they used to not play it anymore. Dress Down. I can end of turn Dress Down untap Verdict, which is kind of okay. Also, just upkeep Dress Down if they have a bunch of mana creatures. It slows them down a tiny bit. Veto. Do they have enough targets for Veto? They have. Unclear. I think they do. I'll do one Veto. And I'll do one Dress Down. I think. Keep the one Chalice for one. No. I'll do tough. What would Wafa do? Dress Down, Veto, Chalice. Cord Evolution. I'll do another Veto. Kind of have already Hallowed Moonlight that kind of does the Veto job, so yeah, it's a little overkill. On to six for my opponent. What about game one? Game one, we both mulliganed. No mana creature, that's kind of nice. Spell, I'll take it. Just to go, so I have counterspell mana for Grist. See what happens. Still have binding options. Maybe I'll just go Eldritch Evolution. That'd be nice. No. 3 mana instant speed. Alright, I guess I'll just bind the wolf. Why not keep the board clear? Damn, these beautiful basic islands. My favorite arts. Actually, not that bad.
mind it. Oh, Boseju? Endurance. Do I care? I don't think so. I do care, but I think I should let it resolve. Botsies. They get to see my hand, but then they have to take counterspell. I'll counter it. I don't want them to see my hand. Okay, I could have hollowed Moonlight Token. Let's see. Looks like I got got. I'm at 12. And my binding costs 2 mana. How could I have played that differently? I could have let them have the wool. Save my binding, have binding for Grist. I would deal lower. Yeah. Fortunate. All right, let's not let them untap was Yogg. It's gonna already do a decent bit of damage. Probably just gonna kill myself to those endurance two rights. Or not. They get to kill Solitude and draw an extra card. I'm not interested to say. I think I forgot to add Kahira access here. That might work out okay for me. They don't have another spell. I mean, they don't even have mana for another spell. Huh. I feel like they might have forgotten about Kahira, maybe. Not a ton of damage yet. Creature cards in your graveyard, they have a couple. Probably lose the dev access to Yawgmoth. They get to draw by at least 3 cards and kill my boards. They don't know about the Solitude. Oh, damn. That took them a while. I'm starting to have hopes here. Wow. Okay. Yeah. I think I'm going to bring a Chalice on the play. Oh. All right, if I Solitude Yogg in response, they're gonna sack free creatures, kill Kahira in Solitude. Soul Transparent, but maybe I'll get at least a little lifelink in, some damage. Okay. Felt like a small win. Oops. Obviously meant to play a land there. Hopefully it doesn't matter. Okay. You have an evolution. Maybe not. Ooh, Hallowed Moonlight. Hallowed Moon Alight. I could use it just for Grisk activation. I think I'm gonna save it though. Well, nice. I'd have another Grist. Yeah. All right. I lied. I might have to cycle the Hallowed Moonlight right away. I need something. Binding qualifies. Another moonlight. Whew, nice. Got a few top decks covered. Don't have a Shark Typhoon though. I did board out most of them. I did board out two of them. I don't hate my spot. Strong of a Hallowed Moonlight. Think I might cycle it. We'll see. If they don't do anything, I'll keep it in hand. As soon as I'm under some kind of pressure, I'll cycle it. That qualifies as some kind of pressure. And yeah, I messed up. I kind of wanted a Moonlight in response in case I drew a counter spell. They got me. I have six and I didn't F5 fast enough. Rip. Okay. It's not gonna work, right? I might as well do it. I don't think it works. I don't think it's a creature because it's already in play, but at least when they plus. They don't get a token, and I guess I get binding right back. Wasn't that bad.
Not bad at all. Yogg? Dang. Okay.
Let's see. I think probably Bind the Grist, right? And Solitude Yogg. They're gonna sag the bird, two new cards. All right, they get to shrink. Let's see, if I bind Yogg, they also sag the bird. Maybe that's bad. Maybe that's short-sighted. Maybe let's bind the Yogg and Solitude Endurance Pressure. Could have said go one turn, I guess. Try and get all extra value out of it. Okay. Not a dryad? I think they only play one. Okay. The wolf. Yeah. Trying to figure out if I want to see what I want to draw first. Does it ever matter? Yeah, 12. Two hits. Oh, they have a Chum Walker. Chump, two, tack, one. They can keep it back. All right, I think attacking is good, though. Do I just steal the wool? All right, if I steal the wool, I tag them down to four. And then what can they even draw? Strangle Root Geist. Oh my god, they have Veil in their deck? Oh my freaking god. I did not think they played Veil still. Wow. Well, better lucky than good. Let's take Charm. And let's take Teferi? Counterspell, Teferi. No card, I have delusion in my yard. True solitude, so now I can pretty much just say go, see what happens. Wow, I did not expect to get veiled. Maybe I should have drawn just on the off chance they have veiled in their deck. I'm not up to date on the latest. I'll let them have it. It's fine. Probably trying to get me to tap so I don't cast Deluge right away, which is probably a smart play by them. Fortunately, I just have it all. Just gonna attack them. I'm gonna gain some life. And their deck kind of just stops to function once they're low enough. It's not like they can really go off. Not that I remember. I guess they could have Besieju for Hall and yeah. Force of Vigor. Wow. Okay, I guess we've got a game. Nice. Well, do we have a game? Yeah, probably. Maybe not, actually. Teffers. Alright, what the hell does that do? Whenever you put one or more mouse. I don't know what it does. It's a little scary. Huh. Let's like upkeep Deluge. See what I draw. And if I really don't like what I see, I can always bring back a thingy. Let's see, verdict. And I guess I'll grab an ending. All right, I guess I'll say go. Because of Stranglerood Geist. All right, I think I got them. Might have made it a little more exciting than it had to be. Okay. All right. This is gone. This is gone. Yeah. All right.
So where did I mess up this game? The binding on the first wolf, maybe. A little too eager. Anyways, while we wait for the next round, I'd like to shout out Ultimate Guard. They have amazing sleeves. They have amazing deck box, katana sleeves. They have their own perfect sleeves for people who double sleeve their cards. They have deck boxes made out of renewable materials. They have deck boxes for your commander deck, your modern decks, your cube, your collection. They really have it all. Great quality. UltimateGuard.com. You can check out their website. And if you live in Europe, you can order directly on their website. And of course, TCG Player and Channel Fireball Pro. CFV Pro is still around. It's part of the TCG Player premium offer. For right under $7 a month, you get the perks of free shipping, and you get to track your TCG orders. You get access to promotions and bonus box, and you get access to the entire CFV Pro content, which is strategy articles, deck guides with matchup guides and sideboard guides, all that good stuff. So yeah, check out CFV Pro, check out TCG Player if that's something you might be interested in. And probably supposed to say all that stuff at the beginning of the video, but half the time I just forget. So yeah. Albert 62 mulligans, and I mulligan, and my hand still kind of sucks. What did he have? Kahira, 75 cards. Okay, so probably Omnav that's trying to get the mana right. Oh man, I think I should mulligan again. I'm gonna keep ending and the lands and the charm. Get rid of Verdict, get rid of Deluge. And keep ending for red and six. Gonna keep the charm for some card advantage. That's pretty cool. Let's see what they're up to. Okay, no, red and six. I'll take it. Always nice. Should I wrap a counterspell? Are they going to play around counterspell when I mulligan to five? Probably not. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and save 2 points of damage. I feel like it's just so unlikely to play around a counter when I mulligan to five. I mean, I guess if they have Fable and something a little worse than a Fable, maybe the bait was something a little worse. Teferi, sure. The red might make them plus, hopefully. No. Wishful thinking. I'm gonna go ahead and just draw a couple of cards for now. I'm not sure ending the Teferi on the one's the winning strat right there. Yep. This is going well. No, I kind of want to end the Teferi, yeah. I do let them untap with Omnath, I guess too late now. I'll let them get a lot of mana. Maybe I'll play in my favor. Maybe I'll play more creatures and I get to verdict more creatures away. Okay. You have a lot of mana. Another Teferi, sure. Okay. That was bad for me. They got a lot of value there. Oh. I mean, realistically, multi-five against a normal hand is going to be tough. Yeah. Damn, Omnath's still a bad matchup. Kira's a little less scary.
It's funny, they're just playing more cards for the mana base. Why not? One thing that's gonna save me, but I guess I'll try. Damn for color on that. Even with the Yorion ban, can't dodge it. 74 cards. Man, they have counter spells in their deck. They probably have a million binding for my shark token, so I'm just gonna go ahead and cast Deluge, have it countered. Hopefully next turn I can flash it back and not have it countered. Oh. Probably have Solitude in hand, a bunch of removal. Might just need that Verdict, honestly. And Mage's Binding. I'm assuming I need to get rid of Teferi at some point. If it gets countered, means that's probably the right choice. Okay. Ooh, Renin 6. No. Oh, math. Yep. All right, Jig is up. I don't have a counter spell. Mm-hmm. Damn, they can even nuke me this turn. Jeez. Doesn't do a ton, right? They bind. I mean, they get a little card advantage, but they're not even bothering bouncing my binding, yeah. Okay. This is going well. Me not scooping here, kind of coping. Fetch land, not even cycling land. I guess I already have 8 cards in hand. Okay. Discarding prismatic ending. Great sign. Oh, I'm still playing this game. Well, I guess I came this far. Maybe I'll time someone out. No solitude end of turn. Okay. Just casually discarding a prismatic ending, no big deal. They even have five mana. Five different color. Still not good enough to get rid of a binding, but yeah. Okay. Ping modes, okay. Surely, sure that Shark Typhoon will live. Can't even do anything. It's like verdict right away. All right, enough. Let's not be dumb here. It's already going to be a 3 hour plus video. No need to add on top. All right, well, that's the Flame Blitz matchup. Chalice of the Void. They have Growth. They have Veil after sideboard, probably. But they also have bindings and prismatic endings, so that part's not great. Let's see. Hallowed Moonlight's not very good. AK doesn't do anything. Dressdown, I don't think is that great because I kind of need to counter the Yelmnaths, honestly. Same for Verdict. I think ending is nice. I think Veto is nice. Spreading Sea is kind of a huge gamble because of Veil of Summer. I'm assuming he boards out Chalice if he brings in Flame Blitz. Even though Flame Blitz has cycling, it's a little awkward. So what would Wafo do? Would Wafo just have Dress Downs? Would Wafo try and get them with Spreading Seas? Guessing that's Dress Down. Oh, bless me, cycle, hit my land drop. Save Shark Typhoons for actual threats. Yawn. Are you kidding me? Oh well. Oh well, oh well. I guess it happens once in a while. I mean, pretty good. As far as hand goes. As far as five cards on hand go. Two mana go. Not sure what they're repping counterspell, I guess. No Ice Fang because they have Kahira. Okay. I'll fetch. Kind of want to get to 5 mana, but also want to draw spells. Namely Shark Typhoons. Don't want to jam my one charm into their counterspell or dispute. I'm going to have to cycle Flame Blitz here, I think. They don't play a Planeswalker.
Oh, well, I didn't expect that. Just gonna draw cards. I need to get lucky to get out of it. Find counters, deluge, more card advantage. Didn't even get punished. Could put Kahira in my hand. They might play a solid naked solitude, but if I put Kahira in my hand, they're then not gonna play their solitude. And they didn't put their Kahira in their hand. So what do they have? They only play solitude. Alright, I'll just say go. All right, I guess this is where Memory Deluge would shine and put me back in the game, maybe even win me the game. Let's go. Let's go. Nope. We've got a game at least for a multi-5. I made it this far. Just need to draw a deluge before they do anything meaningful. They're just sitting on a bunch of counters. That's a great way to punish them. Okay, forgot about that card too. 4 Shark Typhoons, 3 deluge. Let's go. We're gonna gain a lot of life. Buff a solitude or maybe just a binding. Wait, just casting a Kahira, that's the best it can do. That'd be kind of nuts. That's kind of funny. All right, let's see. Solitude first or Shark? I think that's Shark because it draws cards. Very proud. I learned how to use W not long ago. If you hold W and you tap mana when you're like cycling a shark, it doesn't ask you to pick which mana. It's really useful when there's an herb org in play, especially. All right, Flame Blades, my last one, but I do have triple binding for their Planeswalkers. So I guess I'll just say go. Cycling main phase doesn't do much for me. Let's see what they do first. Wait, what? Just realized. Tadine and, okay. Even kill the shark. No binding, nothing. What do they have? 8 cards in hand. Okay. Plotted Strand, okay. 8 cards. I don't know what to do. I'm confused. I will cycle my Flame Blitz. I need to just have all counter spells in hand. 7 counter spells. Veils in Dispute and counter spells. Pitched Solitude. Exiling Solitude. Okay. All right. Play my own. Not sure that counter spell's any good, honestly.
It might just be a trap. Might just be Veil of Summer fodder. Wouldn't be surprised. I think I'm going to use a binding. I have so many. And at least it's not a permanent that gets some value when it comes into play. So whereas when my binding is not the end of the world. I mean, they've got to have Veil in hand, right? At least one. What do you think? They have Veil plus counter, Veil plus dispute. It's going to be brutal for me. Oh, man. I feel like I should just draw cards. They have two freaking fetch lands in play. They get a ton of mana to get some damage. All right, whatever. If they have Veil, they have Veil. I'll lose. Oh, it's probably not a good sign. They're getting like more green mana. No, white mana. Okay, you'll love to see it. Veto. Ooh. Do I need to worry about dispute too? Kind of sucks. I have two bindings, but I think I still have to counter that stupid Omnath. Cause it's just too bad to bind an Omnath. Okay. That went much better than expected. Still bad I'm winning, but better shape than I was a few turns ago. 36 cards left, 35 minus the fetch land, three deluge, three shark typhoons. Like almost like one in six cards, just plus charms. Yikes. I guess they have some good cards too. No. Started off so well. Yikes. Yep. Okay. Only one basic left. That's nice. Lots of spells. Dress down. Nah. Yikes. Okay. If I bind their binding right away, never get it back, right? All right, let's try that. I actually never had that scenario yet somehow. I think that's something that comes up a little more often. Okay. And then down to six, no big deal. Flame Blades, boo, or Unholy Heat, boo. Okay. Got Omnath covered, kind of. All right, I'll cycle end of my turn or try.
Please. Yes.
All right. Can't get disputed. They have a hard counter. They have a hard counter. Another dress down. So is a play, I guess a play is just to hold on to dress down for now. Do I make a 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 6, 6 shark? Keep dress down mana for solitude. I think I just make a gigantic shark. And save my dress down for their next omniaph. Oh wow, they have their own deluge. Wow. Oh man, just when I thought I might have a chance. Brutal. Okay. This is why you keep in Hollow Moonlights. For the combo. But that's gonna take free if it can make them make a mistake or something. Just do it fast, not think about it, make it look like I don't have a decision. I might keep 1 mana up for binding, actually. You know what? I might keep 2 mana up. They're at 5 anyways. But they do have Unholy Heat in their deck. Hmm. I'm gonna make a 7-7. This way I can beat Leyline Binding. Beat 1 Leyline Binding. It's tough. This is worse against Solitude. 2 mana ups worse against Unholy Heat. They've played one of each. Probably have more Solitudes than Unholy Heat, though. Yeah. Rough. Gonna bind their Solitude and their upkeep, try and keep them low. Oh, should have played the Delta to fetch my last basic. Whoops. It's gonna feel bad if I draw the last basic. All right, I'll play my dress down. I'll try to draw something. It's not that bad too. There's a whole, lifelink. It's all something. Okay, haul for Shaikta, Fark. Haul for Shark Typhoon. It's a little slow, but unclear if they can beat it. That's huge. Wow. What a draw. Better flashback Mary Deluge. This is maybe the best card I could have drawn. Well, that's that Veil. I jinxed it. Did I jinx it? It's going to be close. It's going to be real close. Oh, wow. It's going to be close or not. Oh, man. So close. Multi-5. Flame Blitz kills Teferi, but then I just die. Just Shark Doctrine and hope they have old blanks, I guess. Free for haul, and then I can make a 6-6. Could go down to 1. Why not? We'll see. We shall see. And they haven't played a land yet. But they have used Teferi. I think there's too many cards to play around. I just lose my shark to free mana to fairy and pretty much die on the spot. Lose it to literally every removal spell. I guess 4 mana, I'd cast Deluge. Cast most of my cards. Is that lethal? No, still not. Alright, GG's. That was rough. A little tough. Still a tough matchup. Kahira much worse than Yorion, much less scary. My trophies, 0. It's also my first Modern League in a really long time. Maybe in the new season, honestly. I should have many more trophies in Pioneer, to be honest. Let's see. 1. A 1. I think it was the one last week's video, the blue-white control. Well, the metagame plus the last couple of rounds of blue-white. Not bad. Deck feels pretty good. I've been impressed by Leyline Binding ever since people started playing it in Modern with the Fetchlands. I was definitely not a believer, I will say that. I was definitely a Leyline doubter. How people played in Pioneer without Fetchlands. Greg Orange just played Blue Light Control Yurion with a bunch of Triumphs and a bunch of Bindings. JPL man or JPL man. Okay. Can I have more than one land in my opening hand?
Thank you. Much appreciated. No shame. No shame in losing to the best card in Modern, Kahira. Boo. Inquisition, though. I don't think the red-black Grave deck usually plays Inquisition. Might just be regular. Then at Hall, too. Hall, like, a turn earlier or two. Probably would have made the difference. Just thought about that because I like to torture myself. Honestly, Flight of Strand 4 Triumph. Red and six. Nice little Inquisition bug here. Draw the card I need after the discard spell. Nice draw. Yes. You two, Inquisition into Ren and six. Perfect starting hand. Nice draw. What happens to Goyf? Just becomes an 0-1. Target of power is equal to number of cards. Tristan doesn't just kill a Goyf, right? Because it's a star plus one. Not too sure. I should know, but I don't. There's no way Dresdon kills Goyf. That being said, what's my play here? There's like a 0.0001% chance Dresdon kills a Goyf. Wow, fail push for my shark token. Nice draw. Lagana of the Veil. Very nice draw. All right, I'll stop. Perfect card to discard. All right, easy. Merry Deluge. No, Teferi? Ooh, Teferi, yes. Play a land, Teferi plus. Dang it. Oh! I do have a Kahira. Maybe it's better to actually save it. Yeah, that makes no sense. Riveter Storm I'm getting? For my lands? Okay. I'll take it. Kind of. Isn't that card just really good right now? Wow. I am in trouble. Yeah, it's a little better than a Red Reduced Charm.
All right, I need untapped lands. Even that's not even that great. I need an answer to Liliana. That's good. This matchup seems rough, though. It's a lot of card advantage and annoying cards. I guess John's probably just okay, honestly. Didn't put Kahira in my hand, they know it. Could ambush a 1/1. I hate that I paused there. That was bad. I should have decided. I should have decided before passing the turn what I was gonna do. Maybe it's not that bad. We'll see. Time will tell. Ooh, very good. So that's good for me. Commenting on every one of my draw steps. I love it. Not allowed to draw a good card, apparently. Only bad draw steps. Let's see. Play. Kahira forces them to plus. Now playing is just unreal right now. Maybe I should. I'm just going to close the chat. So. Yep. Kahira, they discarded Swamp. They probably just have a land. All right, I'll just say go. Because if I put Kahira in my hand, then I have good incentive to plus, and I don't. And they're still plusing, okay. All right, I'll do Kahira overhaul. Just get on the board, have a lethal solitude. Not that they were not gonna chump in the first place, but. I mean, you can't just play the discard deck and complain when you're open and top decks. It's like life of the discard player. 6/7. Nice. I think this is all better than making a shark. Or not. Huh. I'm going to be. This is kind of bad against seasoned Pyromancer. Let's see. All right, I'll take go one time. If they draw something really good, I can counter it. If they break, I can draw two. Mostly Ordo at Season Pyro. All right, Jonty Jones, Liliana, Renin 6. Probably want to see Flame Blitz, Blossom and Calmno, Hallowed Moonlight. No. Dobbin's Veto, meh. Spreading Sea is kind of tempting. Ending seems good. I guess I'll board out the chalices on the draw. And board out Dressdown and Hallowed Moonlight. I don't hate Spreading Seas. Season Pyromancer. I just got Dobbin's Veto, I guess. Sure. I really want to go and see chat. I don't know why I closed the chat, torturing myself. I need to know. Dang, almost dodged it. Almost. Keyword. You definitely don't keep to cycle in this deck. Being able to cast Binding for one mana is a pretty big deal. Even late in the game, it can be a big deal. Uh-oh, opponent's not going to be happy here. Which one should I use? That's the worst one. I'll wait to see if they like player ran on two, maybe. And I'm waiting on Leyline in case they have a third Ragavan. Unlikely, obviously, and they would have to have a land to dash it, but seen more bizarre things. Whoops. Definitely meant to cycle there. It's not a big deal. It might work out. If they play a Ren here, I can just Delusion to Flame Blitz. All right. Got a little freebie. Beat Yogg, lost to Kahira, 4-color Kahira, 75 cards. Junt in the first match? Oh, the Time Seep deck. Time Seep cookbook. No Murktide this league. No Murktides, no creativity, no Cascade decks. Looks like people are just play a bunch of different decks. Is that good enough? Seems fine, right? Up ending, I can cycle charge. Pretty castable to ferry on free. Demo Lador. What about Kahira this league? The one thing I want to keep track of. How often did Kahira win me the game? It was good against John that last game. Really good. Let's see. I don't think I did much against Time Sieve. Against Yogg was pretty good too, like really good. Yeah, Kahira has been super good. Well, as good as a one sideboard card can be, really, I think. What's up with Basic Allen here? Is he Merfolk? Okay. Let's cycle now, see what's up. Dang. Wow, and I had another one? Damn, that's brutal. Okay. Oh, that was so good for them. Unbelievable. Minus the win cons, minus the card in hand. And they got to see my hands. Like. All right, I think I'd rather get rid of it right away than Teferi bounce, etc. Can get Teferi later. Yup. Oof, 16 cards. Don't I have Solitudes? And I guess that's why getting rid of Shark Typhoon is so good for them too. Gets rid of all the expensive cards. Dang. I'm never gonna play a one mana spell. Plus Teferi. Does that make sense? Probably okay. Again, not as bad this time. Okay. Okay, okay. Let's see. I think Dress Down, Bounce My Dress Down is to play, even though they're a mill strat. I should also check. Okay, this is all tedious, but one, two. Okay, first. How many lands? One Steam Vent, four Basic Allens, two Hallowed Fountains, seven. Seven on tap blue, plus Triumphs, plus something else. One. Two, three, four, five, 6. Oh, 7. Are you kidding me? And the Triumph. The Triumphs are gone too. Man, I think I might be out of lands to fetch with Scalding Tarn. All right, this is pretty obnoxious, but I really should double check, I guess. Fetch of a lands, 2 Triumphs, 3 Shocklands, 4 Basic Islands. Can't get the Basic Plains, okay. 1. Where's the second Steam Vents actually? No, there's only one Steam Vents. It's 2 Hollowed Fountains. 1, 2, 3. All right. I don't know what to do. I mean, just in case, but I think you're on me. Yep. All right, that was brutal. No Emrakul. No Emrakul in the sideboards. Chalice? Chalice for 1, probably okay. Ending pretty good. Ooh, I got Blossoming Calm. Hexproof. Dang. These cards seems kind of bad. Verdict seems kind of bad. Dress down. I guess dress down's the least worse. This matchup is probably really, really tough. And another one lander, cool story. And another one. Well, apparently the deck's not very good when you just have a bunch of one-landers. Let's see, not a bad hand. Just get rid of Shark. Oh, right. Why? Call it just to keep Memory Deluge, honestly, over Counterspell. Let's do that now. They have one less draw step to draw thingy, you know? The trap card. Soul God Lantern. It's the anti-Eldrazi technology. Scrybug. Okay, I got Chalice on the one. That's something, for sure. I'm a surgical leader. It's gonna say Mesmericorp is this thing. Okay. I was gonna do upkeep because of, I was thinking it's when I draw 2 used to play against Shield Red, I guess. But no. Right, let's get rid of it. Let's hope they draw all their 1 mana spells. It's kind of nice they even played Auto Aura. I don't have to worry about Chalice getting bounced. And, oh, there's some sharks in there. Ooh, Binding. Yeah, Laughter is not the greatest against me, is it? Binding and Shark Typhoon.
It's kind of nice.
Binding, taking one for the team. Two of my deluge gone.
I wonder what are the odds they like surgical here. Forget about chalice. I'd be totally shocked. Field. Wow. Actually down to one basic. That is terrifying.
Their field libraries are just strip mine. Jeez. No field labyrinth. Nice.
Draw some cards. Draw some lands. Get Archive trapped. Not much I can do about it. I have to play my cards. Test of Talent. Wow. The mill strats. So good.
And they get to see my hands. Oh my god, just getting owned.
Pretty good against Mary Delish too. So what did we say? Basics are gone. Surely I have a Hallowed Fountain left somewhere in there. Yes, I do.
Got me down to half-life, 30 cards.
Mystic Gate and Solitude, I guess. And let's resolve to Fairy.
Okay. Just plus for now.
All right, I probably have a lot of one mana cards in hand. Just plus again.
Grab the companion.
I'm not sure what to do with Teferi here. I'll plus one more time and then start drawing cards next turn.
What? It's only 20 past 11? Sub 3 hour video? Could that be?
Alright, much worse on the draw. Chalice and all that stuff.
I'm sorry, I'm about to fail to my duty of
recording a 3 hour video with Blue Eyes Control. Please forgive me.
We have Blossom and Calm and Chalice in the same deck. Interesting.
That's a lot of cards.
It's not anymore. Target player. Oh, double crab. That's brutal. Let's see. I'm not gonna lie, I need to look up what some of the cards do. Actually, you know what? Let's just do that. I'm just going to play it now. It's kind of awkward because if Death Trap, you can play it in response. It's only stopping free cards, but I'm going to play Chalice for one. I think I have to play Chalice for one this game. And hope. Hope for the best. Ugh. Gaining life though. Yeah, I think I just lead for Chalice for one. And surgical in response. Flyer has 20 or fewer cards in it. So. Yeah, I suppose just go ending into steal another crab. Gotta be two for it because of my own chalice. Okay. I think I have to steal the crab. It's not great, but then just stem the bleeding. Maybe draw two plus solitude was better. Okay. Oof. Down to 22. Ugh. Seven cards, eh? They're just main phasing it? Forget how these land works. Do you have another one? No? I wonder what their last card is. Is that another surgical? Can I win if I cycle a shark? Down to five, down to four. OK.
Can I win if I don't cycle a shark? Probably not. Oh well. I'm probably gonna lose, but I think I have to cycle shark. Yeah. This matchup's a little rough. Yeah. A strap target? No. Target open mills. Yeah, so the Blossoming Calm at least works against that. All right. Could be worse. Could be better. I like mill and four color. Ran into some rough matchups for sure. But at least we kind of beat the decks we're supposed to beat, I guess. So I enjoyed it. It's fun. It's a good, seems like a pretty solid list. The hero is good. Sharks were decent. I mean, who am I to judge? Waffle is a build that he's been tuning for months now. Yeah, as always, if you made it this far, whether you watched the entire thing, skipped ahead, or just maybe woke up from your nap, thank you so much for watching. I hope you all have a great week. Let me know what you thought about the league in the comments. Leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you like the content, all that good stuff helps out. And I will see you all next time. Take care.